In this video, we provide the solution to question number 7 from the practice exam number 2 for Math 1050. We're given 3 augmented matrices, which correspond to 3 systems of linear equations. And so we're asking which of these linear systems corresponding to the 3 augmented matrices correspond to consistent linear systems. That is, which ones have solutions? Now, we don't need to distinguish between do we have infinitely many solutions or a unique solution. We just need to have a solution to be consistent. So looking at the first one, you'll notice that the last column is all just zeros. This is what we could refer to as the homogeneous system of equations there, because the right-hand side are all the same. They're all zero. The homogeneous system is always consistent because you can always just put in, as your variables x, y, and z, you could always put in zero. Like if you take, for example, 1 times 0 plus 3 times 0 times 2 times 0, that adds up to be 0. And so the 0, all 0, 0, 0, 0, always is a solution for the homogeneous system. Are there other solutions? I don't really care because we just need to note that there's at least one solution. That's what consistent here means. So 1 is consistent because it's homogeneous. Looking at the next one, we do recognize that there's this row of zeros on the bottom. That just means we ignore that row. It doesn't tell us that there's a solution, but it also doesn't tell us there's no solution. We should check that because if the number over here were not zero, it would have an inconsistency. It would be a contradiction. That would mean no solution, but let's go on here. Notice that this matrix is also in echelon form. We have a pivot here and a pivot here. And so we have a free variable in the third column. We could set those to be zero, and we get solutions that x equals 4/3 and y equals 3, and then x equals 0. That would be a solution to the system. So because the matrix is in echelon form, we can very quickly see that it is, in fact, consistent. Looking at the last one here, number 3, number 3 is not in echelon form, but just like the last one, we do have a row of zeros on the left-hand side. When you look at the other side, though, we do get this non-zero value, and so that's going to give us that contradiction I mentioned just a moment ago. So because of the third row of the matrix, we actually have an inconsistency. We have 0 equals negative 1, which is not possible for the real number system. Therefore, we put an X on that. So we see that the correct solution will be 1 and 2, which then leads us to select choice D.